Amen. You may be seated. Okay, so Ms. Walker's going to speak to you this morning about our identity in Christ. That's our theme for this year. And it is so important, boys and girls, that we really, really, really know who we are. Do you know that, let's say on Friday, you don't do very good on your Bible verse? Does that define you? If you don't do good on your Bible verse, does that mean, that's who they are? They didn't do good on their Bible test. They're in trouble. They got a bad grade. No, we're going to learn from that, and we're going to be better next week. We're going to learn how to study God's Word, not just take a test and not just memorize it, but we're going to learn to do what? Hide that word in our heart, right? But that doesn't define us if we mess up on a test or a Bible test or sports or dancing or singing or maybe the Christmas musical. Okay, that's okay, because who are we? Who are we? If someone comes and says, so-and-so, who are you? Can you boldly say what we're about to watch? We're going to watch a little clip from one of my favorite movies called Overcomer. If you have not seen Overcomer, I highly recommend that you watch Overcomer with your family, because it talks about overcoming adversities, hard times in life. Some of you have not gone through hard times yet, but you will. And we need to know how to get through those. But also, in order to get through those, we have to go back to God's Word, and we have to know who we are and what does God say about us. So as we sit and watch this clip this morning, and I pray Ms. Walker can get through it without crying, because I'm a crybaby and I cry at everything. Y'all know, because y'all see me. Y'all know I do. Okay? This is so important, boys and girls. We want to be like this young lady and stand boldly on the Word of God and be able to say the things that she's going to say. Please enjoy.
Anna, you okay?
Ask me who I am. Ask me who I am.
Who is Hannah Scott?
I am created by God. He designed me. So I'm not a mistake. His son died for me. Just so I could be forgiven. He picked me to be his own. So I'm chosen. He redeemed me. So I am wanted. He showed me grace just so I could be saved. He has a future for me because he loves me. So I don't wonder anymore, Coach Harrison. I am a child of God. I just wanted you to know.
Wow. Can you say that? Can you boldly say, you know, if someone came to me and said, Miss Walker, who are you? Would I say a music teacher, a mom, a wife? Do you know I could say those things because those are true, right? Those are things that are true, right? So like y'all are pre-Kers, right? That's true. But really, friends, what we should say is I'm a child of God. I am a child of God before we say anything else. But do we do that? Do we say that to our friends? Do we say that to the world? When they see us, do they say, she is a child of God. Something's different about her or him. He is a child of God. He's different. And do people see us and say, I want what they have because it's different. They handle life different. They talk to their friends different. They eat their lunch different. They obey their teachers different. They respect and honor their parents different. And most importantly, they love God. Do they say that? So friends, we want to be like that young lady. And I recommend go watch that movie with your parents. It's so, so important. But there's six key things that she said that we're going to learn today. And we're going to lock those in our sweet little brains. And we're going to remember those. When we begin to have a hard time, when we begin to forget who God says we are. See, we're His. He created us. We were made in His image. And she said six things that we're going to work on. So I want you to repeat after me. I am created by God. I am forgiven. I am chosen. I am redeemed. I am saved by grace. And lastly, I am because He loves me. And then let's end it with, I am a child of God. Oh, we got to believe that. Come on. I am a child of God. What is so cool, boys and girls, is that we have a God that sent His Son to die for us before we were even born. He loved us that much. He loved us so much. He said, I'll go take care of business for you. I will die in your place for you because you are chosen, redeemed, you're loved, you're saved by grace, and I have a purpose and a plan for your life. And then in the Bible, there's a verse to go with every single one of those. So we're going to go through that this morning really quickly. But then we're going to review those six things. Don't lose those six things. Let's start with created by God. The Bible says, and we all know, who does the creation song at the end of the year? Second grade. And we get to hear how God created everything. All right? In Genesis 1:27, it says, so God created man in His own image. He created him in the image of God. He created them male and female. Friends, that's us. That's us. We're that important. Okay, the second verse that goes with that, Psalms 139:14 says, I will praise you because I have been remarkably and wondrously made. Ooh, those are big words. Remarkably, wondrously. That's what He thinks about us, boys and girls. He thinks we're that good. Is that awesome or what? Do you know you have somebody that loves you that much? Okay, let's go to forgiven. That was number two. Forgiven is 1 John 1:9. It says, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and righteous to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. We're forgiven. He went to the cross. We are forgiven. Number three, we are chosen. I love this so much. We are set apart. We're to look different. We're to be different. We're to act different. We cannot look and sound and be like the world, boys and girls. That's what's wrong today. We have to take a stand, right? Here's what it says. 1 Peter 2:9, but you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for His possession, so that you may proclaim the praises of the one who called you out of the darkness and into His marvelous light. Amen and amen. Okay, number four, we're redeemed. We are redeemed. Look at your friend and say, you're redeemed. Amen. Look at the other friend. Say, you're redeemed. Hallelujah. Redeemed says, Ephesians 1:7, in Him we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of His grace. See, friends, we can't do it on our own. If we could, we would have never had to have a Savior. But God knew we could not do it on our own, so He sent Jesus. Number five, saved by grace. Ephesians 2:8-9, for you are saved by grace through faith, and this is not from yourselves. It is God's gift, not from works, so that no one may boast. And lastly, boys and girls, I want you to know that you are loved more than you're ever going to understand, more than you can ever wrap your head around. When you look at the seasons and you look all that God did, he was born at Christmas. He lived, he served, he saved people, he did miracles. And then Easter came and he died. But he didn't stay in that grave. He came out of that grave. He's alive and he's coming back for us, for those that have asked Jesus to be in their heart, to be their Lord and Savior. And you can do that, boys and girls. It is not hard. God does not say, wash yourself up, get clean before you come to me. He says, come as you are. Come as you are. Come to me. And boys and girls, I want to see you in heaven. I want to do what we just did forever. And if I don't see you there, it'll break my heart. We got to be together. Amen? Amen. He loves me. John 3:16, we all know it. Can we say it together? For God so loved the world that he, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have what? We get to have eternal life with Christ. This is not our home, boys and girls. We're just passing through. If this was our home, oh man, we're in big trouble because it is no good. No good. Mom and dad are good. Our friends are good. Our teachers are good. There's some good food, but this is not home. Amen. When we go to heaven, it's going to be 20 million times better. Okay? And we get to be there forever. All right, we're going to close with reviewing our six things. So I want you to stand. We're going to honor God by standing. Everybody stand on your feet. Say, I am created by God. I am forgiven. I am chosen. I am redeemed. I am saved by grace. I am loved. But most importantly, everybody say it together. I am a child of, ooh, amen. Let's pray. God, you are so good. And you are so faithful, God. Thank you for these words. Thank you, God, that you think that much of us. That you love us no matter what we do. No matter what, God. And we just want to say thank you. Thank you that we have a Father that is living and active, that pursues us, that goes before us, that everything that happens to us goes through your hands. Thank you for sending Jesus to save all of us. Help us to leave here today to know we are children of the Most High God. We are yours. Help us, God, to remember that and to be a witness to those that need it, God. May you be glorified today in all we do. We thank you and praise you. It's in Jesus' name we pray. And all God's children said, amen. Y'all have a wonderful day. God bless you.